Hey, everybody, we're off and running on this getaway Friday edition of Thoroughbred Action here from GPW. Jason Blewett joining you from our clubhouse studios. 8 races on the card, lots of turf, lots of dirt, and a whole lot of track conditions up next. All right, we're fast and firm as we dive into this 8-race Friday afternoon amid overcast skies in Miami Gardens. First race, Jason Beam standing by with the call. We've got a sprint on the main track, a 2-year-old maiden claiming race. Claiming tags are $12,500. Take it away, Jason Beam.
And the race is on, and we had one unseat the rider there. It was the favorite, Volunteer Navy, who stumbled and unseated the jockey right at the start. Sarasota Boy up front going out to the early lead. Friendly Wager and Hard West away second. Third is the Incomodo, going to settle back in the fourth position. A length and a half more back to Hugo Igo. And Brash Road is the trailer again. The number 6, Volunteer Navy, lost the rider at the start. A half mile left to go in their journey. Sarasota Boy, Friendly Wager, those two separated by just a neck as they run toward the far turn. Hard West just in behind them in the third position. Two more back to the pair of the Incomodo and Hugo Igo. They're about 3.5 off the lead. It's another 5 then back to Brash Road, who's at the back. Friendly Wager now up on level terms, and Friendly Wager up to put just a nostril in front. Countering back is Sarasota Boy toward the inside. Hard West loops up 3 deep to come after them, and these 3 lining up as they come to the quarter pole. Hugo Igo just in behind that one. The Incomodo did not go on. Brash Road still trails. They come to the top of the stretch, and here's Hard West up on the outside. Sarasota Boy cuts the corner. Hugo Igo down the center of the course. Friendly Wager still pitching away in between. Any one of the 4 still in with a chance. Final furlong left to go. Hard West in the blue colors and nose in front. Down the outside, Hugo Igo gathering up momentum. Friendly Wager is now back to third. They come into the final 50 yards. Here's Hugo Igo on the outside. Friendly Wager battles on. Hugo Igo. Hugo Igo's going to the winner's circle. Friendly Wager was second. Third went to Hard West. And fourth, Sarasota Boy.
Well, first things first, Christian Torres dumped off the 6, Volunteer Navy, just split his lip, went to the hospital, everything checked out. He hopes to be riding and plans to ride with us tomorrow throughout the weekend. So good news there, and Volunteer Navy was okay. Pretty effort, though, from the 8. Hugo Igo. Hugo Sanchez was definitely the boss here for owner-trainer Elizabeth Dobles. We move on to the 2nd. We head to the turf. We'll sprint 5 coming up on this 3-and-up $35,000 claimer.
And the race is on. Mr. Edgar broke sharp from that outside gate. Our Boy Bodie coming a little bit faster, though. And Our Boy Bodie up to put ahead in front. Mr. Edgar going to go right with him. And those 2 speed away by 2.5 lengths to Blue Bluff, who's into that 2nd position. Island Tap moves up outside of that one to join that one in 3rd. On the far outside, Royal Duke is away in the 5th spot. Then comes Damiano, and it's a long, long last to Shiny Copper Penny, who spots him about 13 or 14 as they go into the turn. It's Our Boy Bodie in front. Mr. Edgar up on the outside is 2nd. Just in behind them is Island Tap in the 3rd color, in the 3rd spot. It's 2.5 or 3 lengths more. Back to Blue Bluff, who's pushed along from the 4th spot. Then comes Royal Duke. Damiano, nothing yet from Shiny Copper Penny as Our Boy Bodie turns for home. Mr. Edgar moving up on the 3 wide side is losing a little bit of ground there as Our Boy Bodie cuts the corner. Mr. Edgar down the far outside. Down along the inside comes Island Tap, who's in 3rd. Blue Bluff trying to get going from the 4th spot, but a final 16th to go, and Our Boy Bodie looks very strong. It's Our Boy Bodie past the 16th in front by 3.5, chasing her Island Tap and Blue Bluff, but Our Boy Bodie going to win this one here by about 2.5 in the end. Blue Bluff was up for 2nd. Island Tap 3rd. Mr. Edgar finished 4th.
Love the aggression here and just the sharp overall sense with jockey Nick Juarez that he had to get to the lead and just let the chips fall where they may with Our Boy Bodie. This was the spot. If he didn't win here on the lead, maybe he had to drop him down, but obviously he made the point and just never looked back. He's a homebred, owned in part by Rich Averill Racing, trained by Georgina Baxter, and a real nice ride from Nick Juarez in race number 2. And with the first 2 down, we'll take a little time out. Back with Friday's 3rd after this. Hey everybody, welcome back to race number 3. We start a $1 million+ jackpot Rainbow 6 on the dirt, going a 2-turn mile with this group of 3-and-up 6250 claimers, and we had to claim the 4 Blue Sky Kitten, claimed by Jennifer Quinones.
And the race is on. Good start for Accountant Q down toward the inside, who clears off at once and opens up by almost two in the early going here. Rego Tangible, their way second, third, down to their inside is Sky Point in the yellow colors, who is away in fourth. Mr. Sense, the gray, is fifth in the early going, and Blue Sky Kitten in the purple colors takes up shop at the back, already about 6.5 off the lead of Accountant Q, who leads at 3/4 of a length. Now some pressure from the favorite Tangible, who gets a little bit closer in that second spot. They're 3 lengths clear now of Sky Point, who races up into third. Rego's on the outside in the fourth spot. Blue Sky Kitten is out of last. That spot now belongs to Mr. Sense, who's sixth and last. About 6 lengths cover the group as they go toward the 5-furlong point. And up on the front end, it's Accountant Q in front. Gadiel Martinez and Accountant Q there. That lead has dwindled down to just a neck now. It's tightening the screws on the outside is Tangible, and joining them on the outside, Blue Sky Kitten, who's made up a lot of ground early on in the race here. So a 1/2 mile left to go, and the picture changes. Accountant Q, though, kicks back inside of Tangible. Blue Sky Kitten, that bid was short-lived, has already dropped back about 3 lengths. Down on the inside, Rego is fourth. Trying to wind up is Mr. Sense from fifth, and Sky Point drops out last. Two-horse battle as they go past the 3/8 pole. Tangible up on the outside of Accountant Q. They are 4.5 ahead of Rego, who's up into that third position. Mr. Sense continues to try to make up ground, is up to fourth now as Blue Sky Kitten drops out of it. Tangible now going to a narrow advantage. Tangible up on the outside. Accountant Q now 3/4 of a length back in second as they turn to the top of the stretch. Tangible goes for home. Accountant Q battles on down toward the inside. Rego continues to make up ground down the crown of the track. Mr. Sense still in behind them in fourth, and Sky Point starting to get going a little bit from the fifth spot. Final 16th to go, though. Tangible, here's Rego up on the outside, who now is the danger. Accountant Q is back to third. It's Tangible in front. Rego with 50 yards to push on by. Here's Rego gaining ground late, and Rego got Tangible. Rego with the win. Tangible was second. Third might have been Sky Point over Mr. Sense.
Love the 5 Tangible. Paca rode his race. Horse ran great, but in the end, 6 Rego had his number. Needed just about every inch of the 900-foot home stretch here at Gulfstream West for trainer Alexis Delgado. And Marcos Meneses, the winning rider on this 4-year-old Florida bred by Awesome, of course. Late pick 5 starts, race number 4. We turf here. We bring on some 2-year-old maiden claimers ready to rumble, and the claiming prices are $50,000.
And the race is on. Good start for Budget Buster. All Gorilla, the 2 outside runners, both got away well. Appraised coming up between horses to challenge as well. Down along the inside, Juan Boley, part of the early mix as well. It's All Gorilla, Juan Boley, and Budget Buster. Those 3 across the track. Appraised going to set up shop just in behind that trio in the 4th position. It's 2 more back to Super Edgar. I'm More Ready right to that one's outside in a space of 3.5. Back to Concilium, who's at the back. 6 furlongs left to go in their journey, and All Gorilla makes it from the outside down to the rail and stretches that lead quickly out to 3. Juan Boley, Appraised, and a 3-deep Budget Buster. Those 3 line up in the 2nd flight. They're 2.5 ahead of Super Edgar, who races down on the inside of I'm More Ready, and still 3 more back to Concilium, who's at the back. 4.5 furlongs to go in their journey, and up on the front end, it's still All Gorilla. It's Sylvia Zapico leading it by 2.5 lengths. Budget Buster putting a nose into that 2nd spot as down toward the inside, Appraised holds 3rd. Juan Boley starts to back up a little bit from the 4th position. Then comes the gray Super Edgar. I'm More Ready, still nothing yet from Concilium, who trails. They head toward the 3-furlong marker. It's been All Gorilla this far. All Gorilla takes them into the far turn, clear by 2. Appraised coming up the inside of Budget Buster. Those 2 second and third. They're 2.5 ahead of I'm More Ready, who starts to get underway, is now up into that 4th position. Juan Boley pushed along from 5th. Super Edgar not getting any ground just yet in 6th. They've all got to come get All Gorilla. All Gorilla comes to the top of the stretch in front by 2. Budget Buster is cornering way, way wide. Looks like being eased out of the race is the favorite, Budget Buster. So they come to the top of the stretch. All Gorilla, here's Appraised. Here's I'm More Ready up on the outside. These 3 right across the track, and I'm More Ready might be going best of all. I'm More Ready and Jairo Rendon now hit the front. All Gorilla battles on toward the inside. Then comes Appraised, but it's I'm More Ready clear as they go toward the wire. I'm More Ready going to win it by 2.5 in the end. All Gorilla was 2nd. Appraised 3rd. 4th was Juan Boley.
Well, obviously things amiss there, turning for home for the 7, the big favorite, Budget Buster, but he was okay and walked off and all that. The 4, I'm More Ready, though, and guess who the stallion is? By More Than Ready. 2-year-old who was just honed in, 3rd time out, dropping down, had a lot going in his favor in terms of who he had faced thus far. He had come out of 2 very solid fields. Alexis Delgado back-to-back wins as the winning trainer, and Jairo Rendon the winning rider.
Good enough as they round the far turn.
And here we go. Welcome back, everybody. Our Friday late pick four on Thoroughbred Action starts on the dirt with this fifth race at 6.5 furlongs. These are 3 and up claimers. Claiming tags are 6,250.
And the race is on. Good start for Charzam from the outside gate. Sighted showing good speed, and these two speed away in the early going. They open up 2 lengths now on Oscar Blues. Pirate's Treasure moving up on the outside of Two-Step Slough. Those three line up third through fifth. They're 2.5 ahead of Cape Marco Drive. Early Delies up the inside, and Bondetti, the big favorite, is 8th and last. Already about 9 lengths off the lead as they have 4.5 furlongs left to go. And up on the front end, Charzam, and down along the inside, Sighted. Those two continue to trade punches. They're 2.5 clear of Pirate's Treasure and Two-Step Slough, who now get a little bit closer from third and fourth. It's another break of two more back to Oscar Blues, who's fifth. Early Delia is sixth. Bondetti and Cape Marco Drive, those two still at the back. They're both about 9 lengths off the leaders up front, who continue to do battle. Pirate's Treasure now joining the party up 3 deep. Here's Pirate's Treasure up on the outside to put a nose in front. Sighted goes along with that one. Losing some ground is Charzam, who's now passed in between horses by Two-Step Slough. Oscar Blues continues to make up ground. Bondetti still trying to wind up as it's going to be cast out 4 or 5 wide. Many chances as they come to the top of the stretch. Sighted in the pink colors, a narrow advantage. Oscar Blues down the outside. Pirate's Treasure is right there, sneaking up the inside. Early Delay. Bondetti continues to progress down the crown of the track. A final 16th left to go. Oscar Blues up on the outside of Sighted. Bondetti has 80 more yards to try to push on by. It's Oscar Blues who hits the front. Bondetti, Early Delay are too late. Oscar Blues going to win it here by a length and a half. Bondetti did get up for second, third. Sighted, fourth, Early Delay.
I'm going to call. I know we have the benefit on this replay show of 2020 hindsight, but 1-5 on the eventual runner-up, who did run well after a tough start. Bondetti was just insane. And conversely, $16, 7-1 on Oscar Blues. This horse might have been the overlay of the meet. Just caught a good field and had a good trip with that no-quit type relentless grind of his for trainer Jose Garofalo and veteran rider Santiago Gonzalez. Let's move ahead. Race number 6 is up next. This will go as the Friday feature. And although a compact field on the turf at a mile, it's just a very good race with a lot of talent ready to rumble in this higher level allowance optional claimer as we go back to Jason Beam.
And our race is on. Good start. The Mighty Judge, Notorious Nick. Some crowding there for Cause for Pardon, who had to take up momentarily as Notorious Nick goes up to make the pace. Face of Victory going to try to go with that one, and they've gone 2.5 lengths ahead. The Mighty Judge, who's in the third position. Cause for Pardon, after that little bit of trouble, is up into that fourth spot. It's a length and a half more than back to Louise Two Guns. Down along the inside is Glory of Florida, and at the back early on is Zippy, as they have 6 furlongs left to go in their journey, and Notorious Nick they got to catch. Face of Victory moves out to the two path from the second position. The Mighty Judge is third under a good hold. It's a length more than back to Cause for Pardon in fourth. 2.5 more then, back to Louise Two Guns, who's in the fifth spot. Then comes Gloria Florida, and Zippy trails about 9 or 10 off the leaders up front as they go pretty decent clip up on the front end. Notorious Nick, pressure from Face of Victory, and those two have now pulled away by about 4.5 or 5 lengths to Cause for Pardon and the Mighty Judge. It's another 5 then back to the 3 at the back, so they're really stringing out here with 3.5 furlongs remaining. Up on the front end, Notorious Nick, Face of Victory has not given that one a breather at all, and they go into the far turn better than 6.5 ahead now. Cause for Pardon and on the outside, the Mighty Judge. Those two still racing third and fourth. They're about 6 lengths ahead then of Louise Two Guns, and it's another 2.5 back to Zippy Nothing now from Gloria Florida. Meanwhile, up front, these two continue to do battle up on the front end. Face of Victory up on the outside of Notorious Nick. They come into the stretch. Face of Victory corners a little bit wide. Notorious Nick cuts the corner. Face of Victory is now back to second. It's 3.5 or 4 lengths more back to Cause for Pardon, and down the outside, the Mighty Judge. Notorious Nick, Face of Victory coming back for more on the outside. Notorious Nick at the 16th pole, a length in front. Face of Victory down the outside with 50 yards left to go. The Mighty Judge is closing in from third. Notorious Nick still there. Notorious Nick going to find the wire just in time. Face of Victory, the Mighty Judge closed in to get third. Cause for Pardon and Zippy fourth and fifth.
How about trainer Sappy Joseph Jr. and a great effort here from the 7 Notorious Nick, and the 1 Face of Victory ran a good race too. But just how Notorious Nick has come on and the way he was able to just hug the rail turning for home, just a really, really strong performance from this colt by Uncaptured. Misael Jaramillo, the winning rider, and leading trainer Sappy Joseph Jr. not only won his 21st of the meet, he is 10 for his last 16 at GPW going back to November 9th. Barn is just scorching hot and fuego as we take one final timeout and return with the late double. And down the stretch we go, everybody. Friday, 7th race, 7 furlongs. We've got some 2-year-old filly claimers claiming prices here, $20,000.
The race is on. Bit of a slow start there for Angelic Nugget. Good start for Fiamma Mama down toward the inside. Tangled Tail, Sade, those three fastest as they come toward the 6-furlong marker. They've already put three lengths then on Amelia Madeline, who's out in the 4 spot. Sue's Monster Baby right to that one's outside. Then comes Angelic Nugget, who's out of last. That spot now relegated to Joplin, who is the trailer. 5 furlongs left to go in their journey. And up on the front end, down on the inside, leading it is Fiamma Mama. Fiamma Mama there by a length and a half to Sade in the 2nd spot. Down along the inside, Amelia Madeline. Sue's Monster Baby is up there into that, taking over that 3rd spot. In between horses, Tangled Tail, who broke sharply, is now back in the 5th position. Then comes Angelic Nugget. It's 5 or 6 more then back to Joplin, who trails. So they take that run into the far turn. And up front, Fiamma Mama still there by 2. Up on the 2nd spot, Sade putting a red blinker into that 2nd position. Sue's Monster Baby now back a spot in 3rd. Break of a length and a half more. Amelia Madeline is 4th, starting to gather up a little bit of momentum as Fiamma Mama comes to the quarter pole. Sade closing in from that 2nd spot. Amelia Madeline going to kick toward the far outside. Waiting for room down along the inside is Sue's Monster Baby. Fiamma Mama turns for home in front. Here's Sue's Monster Baby, who swings off the rail to come after that one. Right outside of that one comes Sade. Down the far outside, Amelia Madeline. A final furlong left to go, though, and Sue's Monster Baby hits the front. It's Sue's Monster Baby coming to the 16th pole in front by 3.5. Amelia Madeline up into 2nd. Fiamma Mama left back in 3rd. But Sue's Monster Baby going to win this one geared down here. Sue's Monster Baby by about 4 in the end. Amelia Madeline was 2nd. Fiamma Mama 3rd. 4th went to Sade.
Well, this was a really nice second out effort from the now unbeaten Sue's Monster Baby. She's a 2-year-old filly by McLean's Music for Monster Racing. Jorge Navarro and Paco Lopez picking up the mount for the injured Edgard Zayas. In the case of Paco, he had been shut out, a rarity, through the first 6. This was win 35 of the meet. He's your leading rider. Nice effort here from the 6 Sue's Monster Baby against a pretty good field of 2-year-old fillies. And we'll stay with the youngsters and stay with the 2-year-old fillies, in fact. Coming up on the nightcap, some maiden claiming juvenile fillies. Claiming tags here are $35,000.
And the race is on. Brad Out of Hell broke very sharply. He goes right to the front. Queen of God and Bunny Princess out in good order. And amongst horses, Royal Chant was out in that 4th spot. Maricopa comes up the inside from 5th. Then we come back to Make a Mint, who's in the 6th spot. B-Wings right to that one's outside. And Silver Palm's going to be cast out 3 wide as they go into that first turn. My Canopy Dancer had to take off heels just a little bit there. Then comes I'll Do It My Way. Gio with 1 beat early on. And that's Sassy Gidget, who trails. So Brad Out of Hell takes the 12 of them into the back stretch in front by a length. Queen of God in that 2nd spot. Bunny Princess 3 deep in 3rd. Length and a half more then. Back to Maricopa, who finds a good spot in between, or right all alone in 4th. It's a length and a half more then back to Royal Chan. Make a Mince down toward the inside of that one. Break of 2 more then. Back to Silver Palms, B-Wings. It's another 3 then back to My Canopy Dancer. Gia has 2 beat. Those are I'll Do It My Way. And at the back right now is Sassy Gidget. So they have a half mile left to go in their journey. Brad Out of Hell joined on the outside by Queen of God and a 3 deep Bunny Princess. Those 3 go to the far turn. Just in behind them comes Maricopa. Royal Chant is 5th, but only 2.5 off the lead and traveling pretty sweetly. It's another 2 then back to Silver Palms. B-Wings, Gia trying to launch a bid, is back in that 8th position, but being pushed along. Brad Out of Hell, Queen of God, and Bunny Princess. These 3 in a line as they come to the top of the stretch. Maricopa looms just in behind them in the 4th spot. They turn for the money. Bunny Princess up on the outside of Queen of God. Brad Out of Hell battles on down toward the rail. Maricopa looking for somewhere to run. B-Wings is also running on. Royal Chant trying to get going from the back. Queen of God is there. Maricopa looking for a split. B-Wings in between horses coming after him. They come to the 16th pole. Queen of God, here's B-Wings right down the outside. B-Wings coming after Queen of God. Queen of God in front. Queen of God 1 at B-Wings 2nd. Maricopa 3rd. Multiple horse photo 4-4th.
And that's it, another Friday in the books. Do keep in mind, back-to-back 9-race programs here for closing weekend, Saturday and Sunday. And a friendly reminder, Sunday is a mandatory day in the Rainbow 6 and Late Pick 5. We'll see you tomorrow. It's a 9-race Saturday that kicks off at about 12:55. Good night, everybody.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
I've been working all day. Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
What do you say?
Tired.
tell you, Jack, I'm so tired.